We just finished the second annual Muslim art exhibition here in St. Louis called Creativity and Identity. We're at the Contemporary Art Museum, where over 36 Muslim artists have gathered in order to display their artwork, share their stories, and break stereotypes. In America today, when you think about artists, the last thing you might think about are Muslims. And we're here to challenge that narrative. These artists have gathered here locally, all with different ethnicities and backgrounds and different types of artwork, in order to show that their identity is related to their religion and their artwork. And we hope that the language that these artists present with today will be used in order for people to get a better understanding of Islam and their Muslim neighbors.
It blows me away. I cannot believe that it's happening now, and then at such a huge place, St. Louis Contemporary Art Museum. Last year, having it at the Glass Factory was big enough for me. And now I'm getting ready to speak in front of 400 people, going on NPR, going Riverfront Times. As a child growing up, I never would have imagined something like this. It's just beyond me that now, here and today, we're having an exhibition solely to represent Muslims as normal people. So I hope that this gives opportunity for the artists individually to exhibit in other places without being discriminated against, so that people feel more comfortable seeing them as normal people.
So when guests came into the event, they saw a few things. First, they got to have one-on-one conversation with our 36 artists, talk to them about their passion, about what inspired them for their artwork. They then also got to speak to our crafters. And our crafters were doing spray paint t-shirt, they were doing henna design, they were doing pancake art, they were doing calligraphy, and so much more. We also have live performances going on throughout the evening, from spoken word to poetry to comedy to inspiring talks. Beyond that, we also have a children's section set up upstairs where kids can go and participate in crafts. So there's a lot going on. One thing that people have to realize is that the American Muslim community is the most ethnically diverse community in the United States. And that is reflected in the art show that happened here as well. After this exhibition is over, we're going to hold a series of smaller events specifically for the Muslim artists so they can come and meet each other, share their stories with each other, and learn about each other. We're the only group in America that's doing this right now, and I hope that next year's event will have almost double the number of artists, but really will create a platform where Muslim artists will know that if they want to connect with other artists, this is how to do so.
This event serves the community as a whole. We welcome everybody. And actually, I recommend that other minority communities try to gather an exhibition like this. Use this event as a template, so that you can represent yourselves. A picture is worth a thousand words. Every artwork here is worth millions.
One of the unique things about this event is all of our artists here are local. They live in the St. Louis area. They're your neighbors, they're your friends, they're your coworkers, and they're participating in artwork in order to share their identities with others. To learn more about CAIR Missouri, our events and projects, please visit our website at www.care-mo.org.